It was 8:30 on a Saturday morning in October 2018. I find myself in a university classroom again for the first time in decades. I was waiting nervously for everyone to settle down so that the lecture could begin. But I wasn't there to give the lecture. I was actually a student with my buddy Edward to support me, like he's doing today. As I looked around the classroom that day, looking at my fellow students, I realized some of them were young enough to be my children. Hi, I'm Carl, and I'm honored to be invited here today to tell you the story of how, at the age of 46, I went back to university to study data science. Let me introduce myself. I've been married to Nicole for over 22 years. We have two teenage boys, Sam and Jamie, a handful. And we were originally from Great Britain. But in 2006, with Bosch, when the boys were young, we moved to beautiful Boole in the edge of the Black Forest through with Bosch, and that's where we still live and work now. Nicole and I met at university where I was studying mechanical engineering, obviously. You can see from the photo what she, why she fell in love with me. I graduated in 1994, and in 1999, I started my career at Bosch. First in Great Britain, and then later, obviously, in Germany. Now, I've had many roles at Bosch, mostly around manufacturing, process development, project management, BPS for a number of years, and then later in divisional quality. So it begs the question, why go back to university and study part-time alongside a full-time job, full-time social life, and why data science? Well, it was a combination of frustration, curiosity, and I suppose fate. Frustration because a lot of us sit in front of these screens every day and we fill it with information. But when it comes to the crunch and we want something back, we have a critical situation, it's almost impossible to get it back out. That became very transparent when I was a divisional quality champion at ED. In the automotive sector, we collect all of our customer information about our customer complaints in a centralized SAP system. And we've been doing it for 15 years. And in that system, there are details of the problems, results of tests, and also information about potential root causes, and even the solutions to the problems. Can you imagine how much knowledge there is in this system and others like it? But we can't untap that knowledge. I suppose, as I was getting older, I was just asking myself the question, why not? It was so frustrating. About this time, my manager, Eva, sent me an email with this link. She said, you've got to watch this. Little did I know at the time that this link was going to change my life. It took me to a YouTube page video from this guy, David. He's a data scientist and actually quite a funny guy. He explained how over an 18-month period, he collected data of over 100,000 articles from the website of the German magazine Der Spiegel. And through some simple analytic methods, and also some not-so-simple methods, he was able to gain insights into that data, but also the company itself. What really fascinated me was this picture on the right, what looks like a galaxy full of stars and dust clouds. Is actually a representation of those articles. And as I zoom in, you can see that the stars are actually words. They are the keywords found in the articles. And they're different sizes, because the bigger the star, the more important that word is in that domain. And the dust cloud, you can see these are lines connecting the words together. They are a relationship between the words. And the words that are closer together, they cluster into topics. Knowledge, you could say. And you can then gain more insights into that data. And as I watched this video for the second time, I started to think, is this what we could do at Bosch? Could we understand the data we have in our systems like that? Has David just shown me a vision of what's possible? I was curious to find out more. And as fate would have it, a few weeks later, I was at a university with my manager, Eva, and we were handed this brochure. a brochure about promoting a master degree in data science and business analytics. I, of course, ignored it. You can't see me on that picture. But Ava said, you should do that. I said, me? You know how old I am, right? But she said, why not? You have this need and you have this idea. Why not learn about it? And you know what? The idea sat with me and I thought, well, actually, why not? So that night, I took the brochure home to my real boss, my wife, and over a cup of tea, we are British after all, we discussed it. And we realized it would be a difficult 3 years. But the boys were needing me less and less, and it would be good for both my professional career, but also good for us as a family. An additional skill in these strange times would give us some security, maybe. So that's how I found myself sitting nervously at that lecture. I was nervous because I didn't know whether I could still learn. Would I be able to understand the lectures in German? Most worryingly was the thought of 16 exams over the next couple of years. But I was also excited. I really felt that I was on the first step on this journey to achieving this vision of making a difference. And it shouldn't have worried. I've thoroughly enjoyed it. It's been a joy to learn. Learning now is totally different to when I was younger. Then, if I had a problem, I'd have to jump on my bike, cycle to the library, and spend hours in a dusty cellar, looking through books and making handwritten notes. Now you just Google it, and within seconds, you're watching somebody explaining it in a YouTube video. And I now stand in front of you. I have passed all the exams. Thank you very much. And I... Thank you. Thank you. I just write in my master thesis now. And I've learned about many new things. And I've seen the potential we have in our data. And yes, I've learned about artificial intelligence and machine learning, and I've learned a lot of buzzwords. But what I've really learned is that our data, the structure of our data and the quality of our data is extremely important. And one of the most exciting things I've learned is a technology called semantic technology. It's the basis of a so-called knowledge graph. And knowledge graphs are one of the methods Google uses to give you the information you request. Because knowledge graphs allow machines to understand the meaning of the data. And I'm extremely proud, through my studies, to now work with a great team of enthusiastic people across the divisions, across the functions, working on laying down the foundations for the Bosch knowledge graph. And it's with this that I can really see at my fingertips the ability to make this difference. And before I go, I'd like to make just one comment. We're in a crazy world at the moment, loads of changes. Almost every day, we're confronted with this digitalization and artificial intelligence. And people of my generation may feel like we're getting left behind. But I like to say, these technologies, if we embrace them, they will really bring benefits to us as a company, and also us personally. And there are so many resources out there, both inside Bosch and on the internet. So if you're curious enough, just go for it. Thank you very much.